Hello everyone, this is Madhavi Kavaramudi, Assistant Professor in CSE Department. In this lecture, I will talk about files in C language. Here I have specified it as part 2. Why it is part 2 is, in the previous session, we have discussed about what is a file, what are the types of the files, and how to open the file, and what are the operations like how to write the contents into the file, how to read the contents from the file. Those things we have discussed. Now in this session, we will concentrate on binary files. So what is a binary file? What are the operations that we can perform on binary files? And some of the operations on text files also we'll see later. Okay, let me explain what is a binary file first. Binary file stores the information in the form of binary format. Okay, the content that is there in the binary file will be in the machine readable format. So here the data will be stored in the form of zeros and ones. So generally, these binary files are mostly the executable files. Whenever you compile your C program, .c file, we'll get a .exe file. So that .exe file is a binary file. So these binary files are difficult to understand. Human cannot understand this binary file content. These binary files will be understandable by the machines. So your C language supports some operations, I mean, supports binary file operations like read and write operations. And we can also open the binary files in append mode. So for this purpose, your C is providing one a library file for performing operations with binary files. So stdlib.h file contains some of the methods to work with the binary files. So if you want to work with the binary file, you have to open the file in binary mode. Okay, so the file mode should be either RB, read in binary mode, or WB, write. Open the file in write mode for binary mode. Okay, you need to use either RB, WB, or AB for opening the file. Okay, so if you use simply R or W, it will open the file in the form of text file. If you want to open the binary file, you have to use RB or WB. Now see the functions that are used for working with the files, binary files. Here we have two functions for reading the contents into the binary file as well as for writing the contents into the binary file. In case of text file, we have three functions for reading purpose and we have three functions for writing purpose, right? If you want to work with the binary file, we have only one function for reading, that is fread function. Using this fread function, we can retrieve the contents from the binary file. Similarly, if you want to write contents into the binary file, we need to use fwrite function. So these two functions will use for working with binary files. Let us see some of the files that are used on text files. So in the previous session, we have discussed about a few functions like how to work with how to open the file, how to read the contents from the file, how to write the contents into the file. Now we'll discuss about how to access the files randomly. Generally, the file will be accessed by using read and write. You can access sequentially. Suppose if you want to access the file contents randomly from the specified location, then we need to use fseek function. So this fseek function is used to move your file pointer associated with the given file to a specific position. Just assume that we are opening some file with the name hello.c file I want to open. Okay, initially when I open the file, my file pointer will be in the first position. Now I want to set my file pointer to the 10th position. Okay, in that case, we need to use fseek function. This fseek function moves your file pointer to the specified location. Okay, see the syntax of fseek, file pointer, which file you want to open or if you want to set the pointer, that file pointer, long int offset. This offset refers to the position. Okay, and int position. This is a position from where you want to, where the offset is added. Okay, so here this position defines the point with respect to which the file pointer needs to be moved. Here we have three values for the position: seek, end. Okay, so this is these three are the constants available in stdlib.h. Seek end constant represents the end of the file. Seek set represents the starting of the file. Seek underscore cur denotes the file pointer current position. Okay, so these are the three constants we need to use to set the position of the file pointer randomly in the file. Okay, we'll have two more functions are there like this. After seeing those three functions, we'll see the example. Okay, next second function is ftel function. So this ftel function returns the current position of the file pointer in the stream. Suppose if your file pointer is in the beginning position, then it will return 0. Suppose if your file pointer is in the last position, then it will return the last position number to the user. Suppose if your file, you have 80 characters, okay, 80 characters including space, then your ftel function, if your file pointer is in the last position, then if ftel function returns 80 as a result, that indicates that the last position of the file pointer. Okay, suppose if your ftel function is in the middle, then that middle position will be returned to the user. Okay, now see the syntax of ftel function. Ftel file pointer, we need to pass the file pointer as a parameter to this ftel, and this ftel function returns the integer. Okay, if it is returning 0 or positive, means it indicates that file pointer is in the beginning of the file. Suppose if it is returning -1, indicates that it is a error. Okay, now see the third function, rewind function. So this rewind function is used for setting your file position to the beginning of the file. Okay, just assume that your file pointer is at the end. Suppose if you want to move that file pointer to the beginning position, then we need to call rewind function. Or if your file pointer is in the middle of the position, if you want to set back to the beginning position, then we need to call rewind function. Okay, so this rewind function sets the file position to the beginning of the file for the stream pointed by the stream. Okay, now see the syntax of rewind function. Rewind file, whatever file pointer you want to open, that file pointer address. Okay, let me show you the execution of how these three functions, fseek, ftel and rewind function, works. Okay, fseek function, fseek function returns the file pointer to the specified position, and ftel function returns the position of the file pointer to the user. The rewind function sets the file pointer at the beginning position. Okay, let me explain these three functions with example program. First I'll check the file name, fseek1.c. okay, this is my fseek1.c file. First include library files. And here all these file functions are available in stdio.h file itself. So no need to include special file. First of all, we need to create the pointer for the file structure. Now we need to open the file with the specified name in read mode. Okay, just assume that in this file we have some content. Okay, now see the file, whether the file exists or not. Yes, file name.txt file exists. Let's open that file. Here we have some content, three lines of text. I don't know how many characters are there in this. I am leaving my cursor position in the last position. See, here I am leaving my cursor in the last position, right? Now come back to the program. Here, fseek function, with fseek function, I am setting my file pointer to the last position, right? Now here, I want to know where the position of the file pointer in the file. Okay, we know that we have already set the file pointer in the last position, and we want to print the address of the last position. Okay, index of the last position and position of the file pointer in the file by using ftl function. Okay, with this ftl function, I want to know the position of the file pointer in the file. So for this ftl function, we need to pass file pointer as a parameter. So what is the file pointer? Here I am opening the file, filename.txt file, using fopen function. If this fopen function opens the file successfully, then it will store the return value in true value in this. Okay, that means that this fp pointer points to this filename.txt file. Now with that I am finding the file pointer position, and that position I am printing on the screen. Okay, once it is returning the file pointer position, what I am doing is, in the next statement, I am resetting the file pointer to the beginning position. Okay, so first here I am moving my file pointer to the end position. That end position I am printing on the screen by using ftl function. After that, again I am setting the file pointer to the beginning position by using a rewind function. Once you set the file pointer position to the beginning using rewind function, again I want to check whether it is set to the beginning position or not, and for verifying that, again I am calling ftl function. Okay, so see the output of this program. Let me compile the program first. GCC filename.c. Yes, it is successfully compiled. There are no errors. Now run the file a.out/a.out, enter. Okay, see here, it is displaying 83. How it is displaying 83? First we have set the file pointer at the end position by using fseek function. Okay, that means that the file pointer is there in the 83 index position. That 83 is returned by ftl function. So ftl function is returning the position of the file pointer, right? So after ftl function, again we are setting the file pointer to the beginning position using rewind function, right? So automatically your file pointer from last position, it is moving to the beginning position. So the beginning of the file will be represented with a 0th index, right? After setting it to the beginning index, again we are printing the position of the file pointer using ftl function again, second time. So the second ftl statement is returning 0 as a result. So this is about fseek, ftl function, and ftl, fseek, and rewind functions, right? So these are the main important functions that we can perform on files random, for accessing the file contents randomly. Okay, so till now we have discussed about all the file operations, like how to open the file, how to close the file, how to read the contents into the file, how to write the contents into the file. After that, we have seen how to work with the binary files using fread, fwrite functions. And in this session, we have discussed about how to access the file contents randomly using fseek, ftl, and rewind functions. So fseek function is used for setting the file pointer to the specified location. Okay, ftl function returns the position of the file pointer to the user, and by using rewind function, we can again reset the file pointer position to the beginning. So these are the three important functions that are used in files to work with randomly. Okay, these three functions are called as random access functions. So with this, all the file operations are over. So hope you people understood. So thank you. Thank you, Anurag.